मॉड्यूलेशन ट्रेनर की ऑर्डर कोड इज़ 40611। सो दिस इज़ द ट्रेनर के, दिस आर द डिफरेंस आई सी दैट इज़ माउंटेड ऑन द पैनल। This is the modulation block and this is the demodulation block. Here this is the high frequency carrier signal and this is the data signal that we are going to that is going to be modulated. This is the carrier modulator, this is the modulator output, and here this is the demodulation block, this is the data regeneration. Here we can see the different demodulated signal and this is the demodulated output here. This is the user manual. User manual and patch cords are included with this kit, and to perform the experiments we will need an oscilloscope. First we will observe QPSK modulation. We will make the connection as the as per the figure that is given in the manual. So first connect this ground with S1 data and S2 data. And connect this S clock to clock input. Now we will observe the waveform, different types of waveform in this different test point that is given in the kit. So first we will observe modulated output here. So connect the negative lead at the ground and turn on the kit and see the modulated output. So this is the modulated output. Now we will observe the waveform. When the ground pin is connected to S1 data, but the S2 data is open. So this S1 data is connected to ground pin. Now we will observe the modulated output. So this is the modulated output when S2 is open and S1 is connected to ground. Now similarly we will observe the output when S2 is connected to ground pin and S1 is open. This is the output. Now we will observe the waveform when both S1 and S2 is open. So connect the CRO negative lead to ground and we will observe the output. So this is the output when both S1 and S2 is open. Now also you can check the carrier data. So we can observe the carrier data in the S clock test point. Observe the data signal also. So as we know, in QPSK modulation the phase angle modulation happened 4 times. So this is here the chart is given for different input combination, and for that input the phase angle of QPSK output with respect to the 180 degree carrier signal. So when we have grounded both the S1 and S2 and we observe the modulated output, we can see that the modulation happened at 180 degree. When S1 is grounded and S2 was open, the modulation happened at 270 degree. And when S1 is open and S2 is grounded, the modulation happened at 0 degree, and when both were open, the modulation happened at 90 degree. Similarly, we have observed the different types of waveforms, and these are the waveforms given in the manual. So you can compare those waveforms with this waveform theoretically. So this happened when the D0, this is the carrier signal, D1 D1, these are the carrier signal. When D0 is 0 degree, when 90 degree, when 180 degree, and this is for 270 degree. Here this one, we will get this waveform when both S1 and S2 was grounded. We will get these waveforms when S1 was grounded and S2 was open. And we will get this waveform when S1 was open and S2 was grounded. We will get this waveform when both S1 and S2 were open. We will see in our next experiment the QPSK modulation and demodulation. For this, I am making the connection as it was given in the manual. So connect S clock with clock input, connect data with S1 data and S2 data. Now connect modulated output with modulated input of the demodulation block. Now we will connect this A1 to A2. Connect bit pair detector B1 to B2, C1 to C2 and D1 to D2. Now first we will observe the modulated output. First don't make this connection. Now we will observe the modulated output here. Now we have checked this. Now also check output at clock generator. Check the waveform at S clock generator. Check the data signal at data generator. Check the signals at carrier modulator, that is S0, S1, S2 and S3. This is S0, this is S1, like this check S2 and S3, and we have already checked the modulated output. Now connect the demodulating input of demodulation block with the modulated output of the modulation block and check these signals at data degeneration Q0. This is the signal. Similarly, you can check Q1, Q2 and Q3, and now check the signal at demodulated output. This is the signal at demodulated signal. So you can compare the graph that is given here in the manual we can compare the waveform given here in the manual with the waveform we have received from the after doing the experiment.